Hey, do you want to see my rack? It's Dactylus leachianus. The New Caledonian giant gecko, otherwise known as the Leachianus gecko, or leachie for short, is the world's largest species of extant gecko. Extant means still existing, so extinct means no longer existing, and there are some larger species of extinct gecko, but the largest one still living on planet Earth is the leachie. They grow up to 12 to 14 inches long, and they can live upwards of 20 years in captivity. Leachies are found all over the island of New Caledonia, which is a smallish island to the east of Australia. This gecko exhibits cryptic coloration, which is a type of camouflage that helps it blend into their natural environment. Although their tail can break off and regrow, the regenerated portion of their tail will never look the same as the original one did. However, their natural original tail kind of looks like a regrown tail. The base of a leachie's tail is covered with this thick layer of extra floppy skin, and the outer portion of the tail is actually a lot thinner. But again, this is her original tail. Like many types of geckos, the leachie is able to stick to smooth surfaces, but instead of using suction cups, it actually has thousands of microscopic hairs on its toe pads that form an electromagnetic bond to the wall molecules, or to the molecules of whatever they're sticking onto, and they have the ability to turn that attraction off and on in order to lift their foot up and take a step. They have these same microscopic hairs at the end of their tail, which makes their semi-prehensile tail basically like an extra toe to help them climb on branches. You can learn more about how and why geckos stick to smooth surfaces in this video right here. Where these are indigenous to, the Kanak people believe that the leachie has the ability to cling to a person's body and pull out their soul. That, along with the fact that they often make low growling noises in the trees, leads the Kanak people to calling them the devil in the trees. But there's nothing to be afraid of with this adorable little gecko. There's nothing venomous about them. They can bite, but if they are socialized at a young age, they are very handleable as adults, as you can see here. Like all geckos, the leachie lays 2 eggs at a time, and they average about 2 to 5 clutches every breeding season. However, they can lay upwards of 10 clutches of eggs, or 20 eggs total, in a single year. In the wild, their temperatures average at about 75 degrees Fahrenheit, although it can get as cool as 68 degrees, or as warm as 82 degrees, give or take a couple of degrees for those extremely warm or cool days. But overall, they stay at a comfortable room temperature, which makes them very easy to keep as pets. If you want to keep a Leachianus gecko as a pet, let me explain kind of how to set up their environment. First off, you want to house these individually. They can be a surprisingly aggressive species of gecko, so it's best just to house one individual per enclosure. The one exception is, of course, for breeding purposes, when a male and a female are housed together during the breeding season. However, that male can only be with that female. If he is introduced to another female in another enclosure, and the original female smells the other girl on him, she will more than likely kill him for cheating on her. They are generally a monogamous species, and she makes sure of that. They also like strong men, and that's why it's important to monitor a new pair if you just put them together for the first time, because if the male isn't strong enough or can't hold his own well enough, she'll probably kill him. Brutal. I guess I'm glad I'm not a male leechie.
Yeah.
Most breeders recommend housing a Leachianus gecko in an 18 by 18 by 24 inch enclosure, although you can always give them a larger enclosure as well, although I highly recommend giving them a habitat that has frontward opening doors instead of an aquarium with like a screen lid that rests on top. Having those front opening doors will make cleaning and regular maintenance much easier than if you're trying to reach in from above. And just like crested geckos and day geckos and many other types of geckos, leachies will poop on the front of the glass. They seem to know what side is the door, what side you like to view them from, and they poop all over it. So get ready to clean a lot of glass. When it comes to substrate, there are a few different options for you. The bottom line is just make sure you use a substrate that holds in humidity well. So a few of your options would be like cypress mulch or coconut fibers or topsoil. We use a mixture of topsoil mixed with sphagnum moss to really hold in that moisture. In addition, you can add some springtails to the substrate, as they will naturally kind of break down feces and leftover food, and as a result, they'll help keep the enclosure clean for you. However, springtails really can only eat the smaller bits of leftovers and feces, so on top of springtails, we also recommend adding isopods, which are like the pill bugs or the roly-poly bugs. They're becoming increasingly available on the market, so they're easier to find nowadays, which is great because they are awesome at breaking down larger chunks of fecal matter and larger chunks of leftover food. Once you have your substrate all figured out, then you can add your decor. The biggest thing with decor and Leachianus geckos is, since they're a big lizard, you want to give them very sturdy pieces of decor to hold their weight and to allow them to jump from one piece to the next without risking something collapsing or falling beneath them. So things like cork bark or shoots of bamboo work really well, like the thicker pieces of bamboo. And of course, you can add some fake or real foliage to the enclosure for added security for the gecko. Because of all the natural plants you can add, the Leachianus gecko makes an excellent candidate for a bioactive enclosure setup. You can add live plants, you can add bark, you can add leaves, but if you don't want to do that, that's okay. You can use fake foliage just as well. One thing that I would highly recommend, whether you're doing a bioactive setup or not, is to give them a nice hollow piece of cork bark, because in the wild, in New Caledonia, the Leachianus gecko spends a lot of time in hollow trees, so you can kind of replicate that in captivity by offering them a piece of hollow cork bark for them to run up inside and feel secure in. Of course, you want to give them a water dish with fresh, clean water daily, although they don't often drink from their water dish. More often than not, they just use it as a bathroom. But hey, that makes cleaning easy because you just take the water dish out, change the water, and replace it. Along the same lines of their water dish, they'll also need feeding trays. One of the easiest things about Leachianus geckos is you can just feed them a powdered diet, which we'll get into later, but you can just keep that in a little dish, and I find it works best, since they're an arboreal species, to have that dish elevated in the enclosure. So places make these really convenient feeding trays that fit the dish of food that just suction cup to the side of the enclosure, and then you can put it virtually wherever you want in their habitat. Having this kind of feeding tray also prevents the gecko from knocking over dishes of food and spilling it everywhere. Another great thing about the leachie is that they don't require any UVB or special lighting. They are a nocturnal species of gecko, they don't come out in the light to bask, and therefore they do not need that UVB. However, if you have live plants, like in a bioactive setup, then I would recommend adding some sort of full spectrum or fluorescent lighting to give the plants extra light for growth purposes, and that would also not be a bad idea for the gecko anyway, because it offers them a day and night light cycle. But to make your life easy, just put the light on a timer so that it turns on and off automatically, and then you don't have to go to the tank twice a day to do that yourself. When it comes to their temperature range, remember in the wild, they stay at around the mid-70s most of the time, so in captivity, if your room temperature of your house is in the mid-70s or even upper 70s, they don't need any additional heat source. You can just leave them at room temperature. If you have a cold house that gets down to like the mid-60s, then you might want to add an additional heat source in the form of a heat mat with a thermostat or a very small wattage basking bulb at the top of their enclosure. We highly recommend purchasing a temperature gun. I don't know where she's going, but you can get a temperature gun for like $15 on Amazon, and then you can actually check various spots in their enclosure to see what the temperature is at, and then you can monitor that temperature throughout the entire enclosure. One thing these guys do need, though, is humidity. They live in a pretty humid area in the wild in New Caledonia, so it's best to mist their enclosures down with dechlorinated water once a day just to keep those humidity levels up to around 50 to 75%. Although it's not a bad thing to let the enclosure dry out slightly in between mistings, so some people will recommend misting the enclosure just a couple times a week, but honestly, once a day seems to be good as long as you don't overdo it. You want their substrate to be moist, but not like soaking wet. What's probably the easiest part about taking care of a leachie is feeding them. I mean, they are racadaculously easy to feed. You just give them a powdered diet, and there are various brands of powdered diets available. Some of the brands include Rapashi, Pangea, there's several others as well. Those seem to be the two leaders in the reptile community, though. And you just mix that powder with water to make kind of a pancake batter consistency. You put it in their feeding dish, put that on the tray, assuming you have one, and you're good to go. Now, since they are nocturnal, you do want to feed them in the evening so that when they wake up at night, they're most likely to eat their food. You can, of course, supplement their diet with various insects like crickets or dubia roaches or so on, every once in a while, but their staple diet will just be that powdered formula. The one time I'd recommend adding something to the powdered formula is if you have a female that's laying eggs. You can sneak in some calcium powder in the mixture and they'll just lick it up with the rest of their food. Like many reptiles, they don't have to eat every day. Babies you should feed about every other day since they're growing at a quicker pace than the adults, but adults, honestly, we just feed her twice a week. And that's it. When we first got her, we fed her every other day, but she would barely touch her food. So a good friend of ours recommended we decrease the frequency of her feedings, so we started doing twice a week, and now she is consistently eating much more of her food at each feeding, so less goes to waste. And the final thing that we want to cover in today's video about Leachianus geckos is handling them. We kind of touched a little bit on their toe pads and how they're able to stick to various surfaces. You can definitely feel the stickiness to their feet when they're sitting on your hands too. Now, babies will be quite jumpy because they're prey for more animals. They're just a smaller size that's probably gonna get eaten by that scary human that's holding them, right? But you just have to keep at it and keep handling them and socializing them. I recommend kind of the same schedule with snakes that you're trying to tame, and that's handling them for 15 minutes once or twice a day for 2 weeks, and you'll start noticing considerable improvements. They kind of slow down naturally as they become an adult too, because they're no longer prey for as many predators, and they seem to become more confident and calmer, actually, as a result. They can, however, still bite, and they have a very powerful bite, too. They can tear open your skin, they can cause you to bleed quite a bit, so you do want to make sure you're watching their body language so that you can put them back if they're getting too worked up in order to avoid getting bit. Then maybe you just give them a rest for a few hours and try handling them again later. Their toes are not only unique because of these microscopic hairs on their toe pads, but they also have a singular claw at the end of each toe, which sounds normal for any animal, right? But these claws get stuck in just about everything, so you have to be very careful when you are picking them up because their claws may get stuck in whatever they're sitting on, and you can very easily tear off one of their nails if you're not careful. So what we do when we pick her up is I kind of hold her body, and then I'll take my finger and I kind of hook it underneath each toe to unhook the claw before I actually pick up the rest of her body. And the last thing about handling is, like many arboreal species of geckos, they tend to jump. They're like crested geckos. They love to leap. You can thankfully kind of predict when they're going to jump because they bring these back feet forward in order to like prepare their bodies for the jump, and then they take off. So again, you just want to keep a close eye on their body language so that you can prevent them from leaping and landing on the floor and possibly hurting themselves. These guys are daredevils. They'll jump anywhere, anytime. I think they have no conscience over their own safety, and you have to be their safety for them. So that just about sums up cool facts about the Leachianus geckos and how to take care of them. They're very similar to taking care of crested geckos, honestly, except for everything is just in a slightly larger scale. I mean, the leachies are a bigger gecko than crested geckos are, so they need a little bit more space, they eat a little more food, and they're a little more expensive. That's because while crested geckos only take a year to 18 months to become sexually mature, the Leachianus gecko takes about 3 years to become mature. That's twice as long that you have to raise a baby in order to breed it. In addition, breeders just aren't breeding the Leachianus gecko as much as breeders are breeding crested geckos, so there's just not as many of them out there. That'll bring the price up as well. So at the moment, in 2019 anyway, from what Ed and I have seen at shows, Leachianus geckos range from anywhere between $500 on the low end to $2,500 on the high end, depending on their subspecies and their locale. That price will probably go down in the future, but right now, it is a rather expensive gecko. However, they are 100% worth every penny. I mean, if you work with them at a young age, they're very chill and handleable, and they're impressive. I mean, this is a big gecko, and they're gonna live upwards of 20 years, so it's an animal you'll have for quite a while. So anyway, thank you again for watching today's Leachianus video. I hope you enjoyed it, and for those of you who are still here, I have a quiz for you. Guess what this is? This was found in one of our enclosures not too long ago, and I want to see who can identify it properly. So comment below what you think this is first off, and then what type of reptile it's from. And whoever guesses it first, I will pin your comments to the top. So don't cheat and just scroll down because it'll probably be there. Try to guess it first and then see if you're right. Thank you again to our Patreon supporters for all of your amazing support on this channel. We couldn't do it without you. And thank you to everyone watching today's video, and we'll see you next time. The leachie exhibits cryptic coloration, which means they have camo- gosh, I'm just... Oh my god. Their diet is ridiculously... Redact. I'm gonna use that joke. She even squawks, too.
Yeah, she's like, rah!
Yeah. Rackadaculously. Hey, do you want to see my rack? Oh, she's slipping. Try again. Rackadaculously. All right, got it.